Well, it's good to be in church tonight, isn't it? Well, we are privileged tonight to have with us two people who have, in my opinion, written some of the greatest praise and worship tunes to be written in the earth in the last few years. And we're not here to make a great worship tape. I don't believe it's going to be great. There's nothing that we can really do about that with all the hard work that's been going on around here. But we are here for one reason and one reason alone, and that is to have an experience with our God tonight. And we've been praying all afternoon that He would touch each one of you in the way that you need to be touched. So, we have no rules. The worship police aren't going to come say you can't do that. Unless you couldn't read and you brought a tambourine or some other noise-making device with you. And if you did, I would just ask you right now, very kindly, to please put it somewhere where you won't be kicking it, stepping on it, shaking it, rattling it, rolling it. Just please get it out of the way. Because we already have a great percussionist over here, Bart. Raise your hand. So, all that said, now I want to introduce to you, what's that? Oh yeah, pagers, telephones, all that stuff needs to be turned off. Anything else? Pacemakers? No, we need to keep those running. Anything else? Anybody think of? anything that might just happen to make noise. Well, alarms on your watches? If you have that problem, just take it way back there. Leave it outside the door, but it won't be there when we're done, but that's okay. I'm going to introduce you to two people who I counted a privilege to call friends, and that Christ for the Nations calls friends, because we've used their songs for the last few years and they have blessed us. Welcome Dave and Jane Billington.
Thank you. It's so good to be here tonight. Psalm 33 says, "Sing for joy in the Lord, O you righteous ones. Praise is becoming to the upright. Give thanks to the Lord with the lyre. Give praises to him with the harp of 10 strings. Sing to him a new song. Play skillfully with a shout of joy." Psalm 98, "O sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done wonderful things. His right hand and his holy arm have gained him the victory."
Praise his name.
To the Lord, sing to the Lord, sing to
the Lord. Sing to the Lord. Sing to the Lord a new song.
Hallelujah, God, you're worthy. You're worthy, Lord. Praise his name.
Raise a shout of victory. but God alone. We will march into the battle with the cross of Christ held high, so the world will see, the world will know Jesus is alive. Lead me to the front lines of the battle where the Lord is marching on. Lead me to the front lines of the battle where we sing the victory song. I want to be a soldier in God's army. Lift me up, Lord, make me strong. Lead me on.
Jesus, you're worthy. Oh, Jesus, you're worthy. Yes, God. Woo. I'm so excited to be in His presence. Carl shared this afternoon that whenever we sing about His victory and about His awesomeness and His power and His might, that He sees that throne room opening and here He comes. The word says in Revelation chapter 5 that there was weeping in heaven. It says, I wept and wept because no one was found who was worthy to open the scroll or look inside. And then one of the elders said to me, do not weep. Do not weep. You see, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has triumphed. He's triumphed. He's triumphed.
And He is prepared for war. He's marching into the battle, wielding a two-edged sword. All His enemies are scattered before the army of the Lord. He is righteous. He is holy. He is the Lord. He's the Lion.
Jesus. God. Oh, you're worthy.
You know, as we were getting ready to do this recording, it was really interesting because God said something that was very true, that the nations need healing. So tonight we're going to sing the song, The Balm of Gilead. Not only is it just for our own hearts and our own lives, but the song is for a healing of the nations. We have the flags of many nations represented here tonight. As we sing this song, I want you to pick one of those flags, even if you don't know what it is. I want you to pray for that nation. Pray for the political leaders, the businessmen, the military leaders. Pray for each individual heart in that nation, that the balm of Gilead would flow from the throne of God over each and every nation. We just sung that He has dominion from sea to sea, and He has dominion from sea to sea. So let the balm of Gilead flow tonight, Jesus, right from the throne room of God.
Our deliverance, Lord. Oh, You command us to seek You, and we will be, or You will be found by us, Lord. We obey You tonight, Jesus. Oh, seek the Lord while He may be in His sanctuary, His praise resounds on high. On high. Come and seek the Lord while He may be found. In His sanctuary, His righteousness will with healing in His ways. Come and seek Him. Come seek the Lord while He may be found. In His sanctuary, His praise resounds on high. In His sanctuary, His righteousness will rise. With healing in His ways.
The balm of Gilead.
The balm of Gilead flows down.
So people used to go for miles to look for that healing balm that came from there. In Jeremiah chapter 8, it says, "Is there no balm in Gilead?" That was like saying there's no hamburgers at McDonald's. It was just unheard of that there was nothing to take away the pain of the nation, the brokenness of the nation. But the thing about it is that Gilead, though it was a great region known for its medicinal herbs, that's not the thing about it. It's the balm. The balm. The word balm means to be cracked open under extreme pressure, to leak forth a healing distillation. When I read that, the Lord said to me, "I am your balm of Gilead, cracked open and poured out for you for the healing of the nations." That's my Jesus. Jesus is the balm of Gilead. The balm of Gilead. Oh God, we worship you. Sing it.
The balm of Gilead.
To heal the wounded.
down. It flows down. It comes from heaven over the nations. The Lord, He hears the cry. It comes from heaven. Precious balm of Gilead. We call it forth, Jesus. We call it forth, Jesus. We call it forth, Jesus. Begin to intercede in your spirit. Stir up your anointing and pray. Pray for this nation. We need Jesus here. We need Jesus here. Pray.
Says, for I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future. So I want you to lift each nation up and speak that to the nations tonight. It's also a song that God sings to us. For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans of hope.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord.
hands of mercy and peace. For I know the thoughts I have to you, declares the Lord, declares the Lord. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans of mercy and peace, for I know the thoughts I have to you, declares the Lord, declares the Lord.
There is surely a future, Lord.
declares the Lord, declares the Lord,
declares Jesus. As you declare it, Jesus, I receive it to myself, Jesus. Oh God. In Jesus' name, I break every lie that's ever been spoken to any person here that says, Lord, you passed them by, that you don't have a hope for them, that you don't have a future in your kingdom for them. By the power of the blood, I break every lie. And we thank you for your word that's true and alive, that we can bind to our minds and say, yes, Lord, you care about me. You've called me. You've chosen me. You have a plan for me, Jesus. Oh, yes, God. God, by your Spirit, just plant that seed in every heart here. You have been chosen. You're called. You're favored. Your favor.
So hear the word of the Lord tonight. For I know the plans that I have for you. Plans of welfare and not for calamity. To give you a future and a hope. Let's sing that one more time.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans of mercy and peace. For I know the thoughts I have to you, declares the Lord.
Take a moment here and introduce to you the bands and singers we have on stage with us. On piano, from Greenwich, Connecticut, Nelson Miranda. From Dallas, Texas, Mark Bovey on keyboards. Oh, come on, you can do better than that. On piano, Nelson Miranda. On guitar, from Dallas, Texas, Mr. Roger Hodges. And back down here, the guy that you can't really see, he's really taller than this. On percussion, Mr. Bart Elliott. And And behind me on saxophone here, all the way from Maple Shade, New Jersey, Mr. Andy Rampula. The man on drums from Nashville, Tennessee, Mr. Carl Albrecht. On bass from St. Louis, Missouri, Joey Cannaday. And the singers. From Nashville, Tennessee, Ms. Erin Horton. And from St. Louis, Missouri, Debbie Amundson. From Glencoe, Missouri. And we have a fellow Canadian with us here, all the way from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, Mr. Lee Henderson.
Are you ready to worship some more? Isn't it good to come into his presence? Oh, he's so faithful. You know, right before we came on tonight, I had the strongest sense of people that maybe feel like God's passed them over. Like maybe God, all this stuff that's happening to me just means you don't want me anymore. Or maybe I turned right when I should have turned left, and Lord, somehow that wasn't good enough. You know, I wrote this song, I Will Wait for You, out of Psalm 130 and Psalm 63, in a time in my life when I really felt that way. And you know what? The Lord says, hey son, hey daughter, hey beloved, I'm your hope, I'm your strength, I'm your light, I'm your life. Watch for me, look for me. Wait for me. And I remember getting up real early one morning, and I was really troubled in my soul, and that scripture came to me more than the watchman for the morning. Oh God, I'll wait for you. A hunger and thirst after you, Jesus. You know, I believe that we have missed that in the church, and that's what the Holy Spirit wants to say tonight. Come on, church, wait on me. I'm here and I'm waiting. I'm longing, I'm thirsting, I'm desiring to just pour out myself over you. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Lord, my God. Oh, Lord, my God.
you. I'll wait for you, Jesus.
Thank you.
to be in your sanctuary, God. There's no other place to be. There's no other place we'd rather be but in your presence. So he beckons us to come. To come into his presence. To sit at his feet. To hear the words of God.
As I come into your presence, past the gates of praise, into your sanctuary, till we're standing face to face. I look upon your countenance, I see the fullness of your grace. I can only bow down and say, you are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise. To you our lives we raise. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father. You are worthy of all praise.
Mighty God. Mighty God.
You're worthy, God.
You call me, I will come. To your sanctuary, I will run. I'll leave it all behind, my selfishness, my pride. I'll lay it all aside. This is my heart's cry. Oh, how I long to come into your holy place to behold the Lamb and bow before your throne of grace. Oh, how
my heart's cry.
What can I offer unto you, who made the world and all things new, and knew my name before time began? What can I give to you who reigns, who owes no debt to anything? All I have, Lord, is my praise. I will worship you in spirit and in truth, for by your righteousness and grace you brought me through. I will worship you with all that is in my soul, until my last breath, the time you call me home. And I will not forget, you gave your life, so yet I will praise, I will worship you. You gave me life, you gave me breath, and you guide my way with tenderness. I know you claimed me as your own. If I'm known to heaven but not by men, still you know my heart and who I am. I come with nothing more but praise. I will worship you in spirit. God, we come to you with nothing but our praise, nothing but our worship, God. To give you all the glory and give you all the honor. Nothing but our praise. Sing that chorus again.
As we stand before Him, just so reminded of how little we have to offer You and how much You have to offer us, God. And even as small as we are, Jesus, You loved us so much, God, that You sent Your only Son to die so that we will be made whole and be reunited with You. I'm humbled again in Your presence, Jesus. Oh God, Lord, my Redeemer, I lay every crown at Your feet, God. I give You the honor and the glory and the praise. I will sing for my Redeemer lives. I will glorify His name. I will sing sin and shame. Washed in the blood of the Lamb. Father, I pray for everyone here who struggles with shame. All of the times, God, when we have let you down. I know, Lord, I'm one. The devil beats me to death with it. And Lord, I lift up every person here who struggles with that evil thing. Because it's from the pit of hell. I thank you, Lord, that there is no condemnation in Christ Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that you loved us then just like you love us now. I thank you, Lord, that you are the one who breaks the yoke. Lord, you are the one who sets the captives free. You are the one who brings deliverance, Lord. Lord, you have the keys. You have the keys. Go down even to the pit of hell that's still clinging to us and unlock every door, God. Now usher in your holy, holy spirit and set us free. I'll do that here tonight. Once and for always, God. Set your people free. You're so good, Lord. You're so good, Lord.
Now, there are times in our lives events that define our lives. And we look back on those times, times where we've been broken, times where we've been battered, times where we wonder if we're really going to make it at all. And where you think there's nowhere to turn. Well, Jesus is the place to turn. Because before time began, he knew you. And before time began, he loved you. He had that plan, he had that purpose. All written down on the palm of his hand, just like your name. He does not forget. His arm is not too short to reach you tonight. His hand is not too weak. He is the God who made you. He is the God who formed you to worship him, to go and proclaim his word. So the times that you are going through
and the times that some of you will go through, you may think that God is not there, but God is there. Just as He was with the Israelites when they crossed the Jordan River into that new and promised land, so the Lord your God is with you. Right where you stand tonight, the Lord your God is with you. When the Israelites had finished crossing the Jordan, they took those remembrance stones and they placed them. So this is to be a remembrance. It's not a place to go back to and live in. It's to be a place of remembrance for the faithfulness of the Lord their God. Now He brought them through the desert. How He brought them through the times of trial and struggle. The Lord God delivered them into that land that He had promised. So the Lord would say, what have I promised you tonight? That thing that I had promised you, don't despair. Don't give up. For I am the Lord your God, and I will deliver you. Hear my word. Hear my word, says the Lord. I will deliver you. So these times, remember them. Don't live in them. They're not a place to go back to. As the Israelites crossed the Jordan River into the new land, so cross your Jordan River into the land that God has promised you. For He is a holy, faithful, and just God. He does not lie. His words are true.
Time. Yeah. such a time as this to the one who bought our freedom and covered all our sin. We will run, lifting up the banner of His righteousness. We have come into the kingdom for such a
Jesus.